Okay, class, now we go to effective rate and nominal rate. Nominal rate to effective rate. You still remember in the first video I showed it to you, if interest compounded annually, so which is satu tahun interest generate satu kali, this is what we call as the effective rate. Okay? Kalau interest compounded monthly, compounded quarterly, or which is kalau interest itu generate lebih daripada satu kali dalam satu tahun, this is what we call as nominal rate. Okay, so in this subtopic we are going to find out what is the relationship between effective rate, nominal rate, or nominal rate kepada effective rate. Okay, so in a normal situation, kalau contohkan, when you go different bank, sometimes they will offer different rate. Okay? Let's say for example, bank A, they offer 3.5% compounded annually. Okay? But bank B offer you 3.2% compounded monthly. Okay? Now, kalau ini adalah saving, maksudnya kamu nak masukkan duit, mana satu bank yang kamu nak masuk? Mesti kamu akan pilih interest yang paling tinggi kan? But in this situation, you will find out that oh, interest ini adalah compounded annually. Maksudnya satu tahun interest masuk satu kali saja. Tapi ini 3.2% compounded monthly. Maksudnya ialah interest akan masuk every month. So here you will be in dilemma. Which one should you go? Okay? So here you have to convert either one of the interest here. So you have to compare. Okay? So normally in a very normal situation, we'll normally convert nominal rate to effective rate. We will convert nominal rate to effective rate. Why? Because paling senang. Okay? So, this one is, we call it 3.5% compounded annually. This will be your effective rate. 3.2% compounded monthly. This one will be your nominal rate. Okay? So here, what you need to do is, you need to convert nominal rate to effective rate. Why we need to compare? So normally we say that if I want to compare, okay, mana satu durian lebih nyaman? So saya akan compare durian dengan durian. Durian Musang King dengan durian kampung. Okay, contohlah kan, we compare durian with durian. It is impossible that you compare durian with apple, or durian with orange, or durian with banana. So you compare durian with durian. Okay, maksudnya ialah this one is a nominal rate. So if you want to compare, you need to convert this into a effective rate. You need to convert it into effective rate. Or if you want to compare, right? You need to convert effective rate to nominal rate to compare as well. Up to you which one you like. Okay? So to convert, this will be your formula. 1 plus K M M. Okay? 1 plus R equals to 1 plus K M M. So how do you masukkan information dalam formula ini? Senang saja. Okay, 1 plus R. R is the things that you would like to find out. Some of the students, they have a common mistake. How common the mistake is? They put R in it sebagai 0.035. Okay? They put this one at 0.035. They put this one at 0.032. Okay? Sorry, no. You forgot about this. You don't look at this. Now you need to convert this into R. Okay? So you don't jangan kamu tengok ini. Masukkan saja 1 + 0.032. Compounded monthly 12, kuasa dengan 12. Now, try to use the calculator skills that I teach you guys before that. Okay, you try to find out the number of unknown here. What is the value of unknown? 1 plus 3.25%. Meaning to say that if I convert 3.25%, 3.2% compounded monthly, convert it into compounded annually, saya akan dapat 3.25. Okay? Now is the time for you to compare. 3.25%, this one sudah compounded monthly, sudah tukar kepada compounded annually. Okay, so you compare this with this. Okay, so which one will have a better return? Compare 3.25% compounded annually and 3.5% compounded annually. Which one will give you better return? Okay, for sure, 3.5% will give you better return. So of course you will choose bank number A. Okay? So try to look at question number 3.9. Okay? Look at the question at 3.9. So this one is very useful, especially when you go to bank and you would like to find out which bank give you a better offer. Okay? Kalau soalan itu adalah tentang borrow, pinjam duit. Okay? Bila pinjam kamu nak bayar kan? So you have to choose the lowest interest. Kalau itu adalah saving, mesti kamu pilih interest yang lebih tinggi. Okay? So you look at question 3.9. Find the effective rate which is equivalent to 16% compounded saving annually. So this question very straightforward. If find out that what is the effective rate, which is equivalent to 16% compounded semi annually. Okay? So this question would like to find out what is the effective rate. What is the effective rate? What is this rate? If the K is equals to 16% compounded semi annually. Okay? So now what is the formula you need to use? This will be the formula 1 plus K M M. Okay? So 1 plus R equals to 1 plus K 0.16 over semi annually 1 tahun 2 kali. Okay? Try to find out what is your answer. Try to find out what is your answer. So my answer will be 16.64%. Okay? 16.64%. Use the calculator skill that I teach you at the beginning of the class. Okay? You can find out what is the unknown. Okay? Now, again, I'll tell you what is the common mistake that students do. The common mistake that students do is the common mistake, please don't do that in your exercise, okay? They will do something like this. Okay, let's say for example, they will be blur here. If the question already give you another, okay? They might be thinking, oh miss, I think it's like this. One expect A give them 15.2% compounded annually. Okay. Bank B provided 14.5% compounded money. This is the example that I teach you just now, right? So now you have to identify which one is effective rate. So here, this one is your effective rate. So this one is your nominal rate. Okay? Now you would like to compare. When you compare, you need to convert the nominal rate to effective rate. Remember that. You need to compare, you need to convert your nominal rate to your effective rate. So 1 plus R equals to 1 plus K and M. 1 plus R, 1 plus K, 0.145 over compounded monthly, which is 12. Okay? Your R will be 15.5%. Okay? 15.5%. So, if Kang wish to borrow money, borrow, pinjam duit. So mana satu kamu akan pilih? Okay? Pilih yang lebih besar punya kah atau pilih yang lebih kecil interest? Borrow ah, borrow. So kalau pinjam duit, you will choose the lowest interest. Kalau dia adalah investment, melabur, okay, you will choose the highest interest. Kalau dia adalah borrow, you will choose the lowest interest. Okay? Now, common mistake that student do, common one. Student will be confusing here, why? Common mistake that student do. Okay? They will be confusing. Is it I put R? R is here leh. Can I put like this ah? No. Jangan kacau apa yang dalam effective rate. Okay? Why? Because you find out this, when you convert this into a effective rate, okay, which is your 15.5%, then baru kamu compare dengan yang ini. This one is for you to compare. Bukan suruh kamu cari. Understand? Okay, that is the common mistake that students do. Okay, now if nominal rate to nominal rate, ada juga nominal rate to nominal rate, which is 1 plus K M M. 1 plus K besar, M besar, dan M besar. So this one is nominal rate to nominal rate. As you know that, we have a different interest, which is compounded monthly, compounded quarterly, compounded semi-annually, and so on. Okay? So, the how are you going to do it is the same. You have to identify one percentage whereby it's for you to compare. Let's say, for example, I have 10% compounded semi-annually, and I have 9.5% compounded monthly. Okay, so here I have to identify that. I have to identify which one I need to compare. Okay, so if this is semi-annually, meaning to say that I would like to convert, saya nak tukar money kepada semi annually. Kalau saya nak tukar money kepada semi annually, macam mana? Okay? So ini jangan kamu kacau. Ini adalah bagi kamu untuk compare. Okay? This is for you to compare only. Now look at this. Sama saja. One plus. Now you need to convert money kepada semi annually. Equals to 1 plus 0.095 12 12. Okay, so are you going to put 0 ini. Okay? So, gunakan kalkulator kamu to find out. 1. So what is the answer? So my answer is 0.0969, which is 9.69% in compounded saving annually. Meaning to say that 0.5% compounded monthly is the same as 9.09 compounded saving annually. Then I take this to compare with this. Okay? So, kalau dia adalah saving, of course saya pilih yang ini. Kalau dia adalah borrowing, of course saya pilih yang ini. Okay? So, ingat, this one is for you to compare. Okay? For you to compare. Don't put everything inside here. Okay? You have to have your clear mind to identify which one should you convert. For me, I convert compounded money to compounded saving annually. Okay? So, any question here before we move to the next subtopic? Okay? There's a lot of questions in your notes. Try to read it. Okay?